Who says I can't get stoned? Turn off the lights and
hey guys, we're just doing an quick update video. Kyle just showed you two of our incubators that we made. We're just gonna go ahead and show you the new reptiles that we just got, and we're gonna show you in the end how to make a homemade incubator. So it's gonna be kind of fun, so just stay tuned for that. Recently, we know what, we got a couple new things. In the Tupperware here, we got ourselves a Madagascar golden hognose patternless, and he is quite active now. He's got a lot of heat in there, he's hissing a little bit. But these guys are really cool. I haven't been able to actually find a picture of one that will be identical to this one. So if you can find it, oh, he's going into the wrong area. That's his old cave. All right, that guy's new. If someone could find a picture online, that'd be kind of cool, because I haven't been able to find one. My reptile supplier actually gave me that. Over here, we got ourselves a giant leopard gecko. Male, pretty big, one of the biggest leopards I've personally handled. This guy's pretty massive. They're slightly bigger than your typical leopard gecko. These guys, they'll get up to about 95 grams, so that's pretty heavy. Normally you get females that are around 50, 65, up to 75, 80 when they're pregnant, but these guys stay around 95 grams, which is really heavy. Over here we also got two more, oh my goodness, here's our females once again, guys. We've got 10 now. Had 8 before, and I had some friends come by and see my stuff, and they really liked it, so they wanted to get rid of some of their leopards. So we just got this little guy, or girl, pretty skinny, we just got it, so we're fattening it up right now. And then this one I think is really cool. It's got some yellow to him. It's a hypo. The white in the tail I think is really cool, and I think it's cool how it comes white up here. It's kind of neat. It's a little different. And we had eggs this morning. I was doing what I'm doing right now and found some eggs this morning. So other than that, we just did some cleaning, nothing too new, but the incubator. Something kind of cool. I'm really proud of this thing actually. I think it's kind of neat. Basically, I just took some styrofoam boxes from work. You get them in a fish order. You can probably go to your local pet store and ask them for their extra boxes. You can just go to a pet store, Petland, wherever, your local shop. Go in there and ask them if they keep their boxes or they just throw them out, because sometimes they just throw them out. So maybe they can keep one for you, because these things are awesome. And basically, all I did was I got a viewing panel here, and it's just a CD case, really. I just broke off the CD case, put it here, cut it, and then just stuffed it right in there, and it worked out. And I taped the sides so that no heat would escape too much. Then we just have a digital thermometer here, an ExoTerra one, and it tells us the hottest that it gets, the coolest that it gets, and the current temperature. So I think it's really cool. And then we're gonna go ahead and look inside. So I have two things of water in here to keep the humidity up, and right now it's at 75%. We have another, a Fluker's thermal hydrometer in here. Then we have right here some heat tape connected to our Helix thermostat. Any thermostat will work. You can get any type of thermostat you want. Just go to your local hardware store, see if they have, in the electrical area, they'll probably have some kind of thermostat. They range in price. You can get $60 ones, $100 ones. It all depends what you're using it for. But you basically rig up a piece of heat tape, put it on the side, and then you put your probe here in the middle. So that it regulates the ambient air temperature inside. So it's not regulating inside the egg container like a lot of people would do. So therefore we can just put containers and containers of eggs in here. Every time we get eggs, put into a new container, put it underneath the old ones and rotate them, because those top ones are gonna hatch sooner than the bottom ones. So we're just gonna keep rotating them. So basically that's a incubator. It's not that hard to make. And those are our new eggs we got this morning from the hypo. So we're gonna be looking at hatching those in 2 months. So May, right? May, March, April, May. Yeah, May, mid-May, late May, I'm going to say. We're going to be seeing some babies, so stay tuned for that. We're around May, we'll be posting a video for sure when we get them hatched, so that'll be kind of cool. Other than that, guys, that's an update video. That's all we got for now. And we're going to do some more, we're going to try and get some more feeding videos and fight videos and just try and have some fun with videos, because it's a lot of fun. And I love your guys' comments. So you guys, you know, I love the comments. It's so appreciated. It's great. So keep those coming. Let me know what your favorite thing is. I have a different video, reptile room video. Let me know what your favorite animal is here, or just your favorite reptile in general that you have or that you'd love to have. And that'd be really cool. I like your guys' feedback. So that's all for now.